Hello, Howie Bentley, guitarist and founder of the heavy metal band Cauldron Born. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about the forthcoming album from the band. It's called Cold Steel for the Necromancer. And the title was taken from my book, which is a work in progress, a novel about the barbarian swordsman Argentier, who transforms into a werewolf. I've written a number of stories so far about the character, and they're collected in my book, The Snake Man's Bane. Some of you may have read that already. Sword and Sorcery. I'm very influenced by Robert E. Howard, H.P. Lovecraft, Clark Ashton Smith, Carl Edward Wagner, and those sort of writers. And I want to tell you a little bit about the our crowdfunding campaign. We really need you guys to get behind the album and help us see it manifest. The musicians in Cauldron Born on vocals: Matthew Knight, who was on our previous album, Legacy of Atlantean Kings. First time I've had the same singer two albums in a row with Cauldron Born, and I think we found a keeper with Matthew, fantastic singer, and also very much into the sword and sorcery aesthetic that's in my music. And we have myself, of course, playing guitar, and I wrote all the material, lyrics as well. And we have Alex Parra playing second guitar and doing some guitar solos on the album. Alex is also engineering and producing, along with the band, the album. And we have a new bass player, Mike LaPond, known for his work with Symphony X, will be playing bass on Cold Steel for the Necromancer. And last but not least, we have Bill Parsons playing drums, who has been the original Cauldron Born drummer since I started the band in 1994. Bill and I started it in a little warehouse, just he and I playing together on a bunch of songs I'd written. Okay, so we really need to get you all behind this, get you back in this, so we can have an album out in April. I want to say mid-April. I plan on starting to ship on or around April 20th, sooner if possible. And let me go over a few of the, we'll say the tiers or levels here. The first one is a digital download of the album for $10. From there, we go to the second level, which will be a signed CD, hand-numbered, and your name on the thanks list, with an extensive booklet with lyrics and photos. And that is $25 plus shipping to wherever you are, whatever the shipping is there. From there, we move up to the next level, is the signed CD, is with all the features I just mentioned, plus a handwritten signed lyric sheet. And that is $35, again, plus shipping. And then we go to the next level, which is the signed CD, the handwritten lyric sheet, signed, and t-shirt. And I will mention, this is a limited edition t-shirt. There will be no more made after the crowdfunders, or those who back the crowdfunding campaign, get theirs. And the same for the album cover. This is a limited edition album cover, and it does not have Thorn on it like the other Cauldron Born albums in the past have. It has Argentier. So the signed CD, the lyric sheet, and the t-shirt can be had for $60, and again, plus shipping. And then we go on up from there, and you get all of that, plus you can get two guitar lessons with me. I've taught guitar lessons for, I taught almost 28 years. I don't teach so many of them anymore, but we'll be glad to. Of course, what I'm specifying here is I'll be teaching only songs and licks and solos from the album, or any other, I mean, if it's some Cauldron Born stuff I can remember from the past, I don't mind showing you that. But anyway, you get all this plus two guitar lessons, and that's $150 plus the shipping for the merchandise additional. And then we have the top of the heap here. You get everything I just mentioned, and plus you get a riff tape, one of my original riff tapes. What those are is, when I'm composing songs, I tell myself, I play riffs and and pieces and do songs and pieces, and I tell myself how I played them, because tape decks play at varying speeds and it's sometimes hard to hear the exact pitch. It moves the pitch around. You can get the riff tape and all the perks I mentioned for $1,000. Original riff tape. Of course, I retain the copyrights to the songs. So the reason I'm asking you all to back it this time is these albums are very expensive to make. We're going to go all or nothing. My goal is $7,500. I want to go over some of the expenses with you so you can understand what I'm out here. Studio time is going to be $2,100. CD duplication is $1,900. And then my Marshall amp just crapped out on me while I was playing the other day. It's going to have to be repaired. Plus, I had to have it serviced anyway before I record. I always make sure they're in top shape before I record an album. But I have the Mesa Boogie dual rectifier and the Marshall that I use on the album, along with guitar setup, strings, and so on. So we're looking at $500 there for equipment repairs and maintenance and musician fees. Look, Cauldron Born is my baby. I write all the music, I write all the lyrics, the basic vocal melodies and everything. So these guys are great enough to help me out making this album. So they need to be compensated somehow. So I have $2,500 in musician fees. And then the album cover was $400, a limited edition album cover. Only you will get this for backing this campaign. And there won't be any more albums pressed. If there are subsequent pressings of this album, they will not be with this album cover. So it's a one-time thing for the backers. And same for the t-shirt. The album cover will be on the t-shirt, but there'll be no more t-shirts made after the crowdfunding campaign is fulfilled. And then I have video editing that I have to take care of too, which will be at least $100. So we're setting the goal for $7,500. And like I said, it's all or nothing. If you back this and we do not meet our goal, then your money will be refunded. Thanks for watching this video and for supporting the new Cauldron Born album. The material is killer, and I know you're going to love it. I just need your support to make it happen. Thanks in advance.